Hi students, in this video I'm going to introduce the idea of linear relations. Alright, by the end of this video you should be able to define what a linear relation is. You should be able to sketch a linear relation by using a table. You should be able to identify the x and y intercepts of a linear relation from a graph or a table. And you should also be able to decide and justify whether a point that's provided is on a given line. Alright, so a linear relation is a set of ordered pairs, that is, just a set of coordinates that when you plot them form a straight line. Now, what we've got as an example is this table here, where we've got an x coordinate and a matching y coordinate. So together, these two values produce the coordinate negative 3, negative 1. This value here produces the coordinate 0, 2. That's how we can read it off a table. Now, when we plot these points and plot these coordinates, like this one here, which is negative 3, negative 1, and this one here, which is 0, 2, when we plot all of these points, they form this nice straight line. So this table and this graph represent a linear relation, because when we plot those points, they form a nice straight line. Now, some other things to know. The x-intercept is the x-coordinate where our graph cuts the x-axis. So looking at our graph here, we've got our x-axis here and our y-axis here. So our x-intercept will be this coordinate here. And so what value is it that we're reaching here when we're cutting our x-axis? That's our value of x equals negative 2. Now, our y-intercept, well, we found that already. Our y-intercept is y equals 2. This is where our graph cuts the y-axis at a value of y equals 2. So, linear relation, we know that definition. We also need to know what we mean when we talk about the x-intercept and y-intercept of our graph. All right, so students, in this example, we want to draw a linear relation. So we've got our equation, y equals negative 2x plus 1, and we have to use a table, and we're using our x values between negative 3 and positive 3. Now, all we're going to do to sketch this linear relation is substitute each x value into our equation, get a y value, and then plot it as we go. So to start off with, we've got our equation y equals, and then we've got negative 2 times, and for this first point we're going to substitute in x equals negative 3. So substituting in negative 3, 2 times negative 3 is positive 6, positive 6 plus 1 is 7. And so when I substitute in that value of negative 3, we get a y value of positive 7. And that gives me an ordered pair that I can plot. Negative 3, 7. So on my graph here, I'll go to negative 3, and then up to 7. Plot my point. They're ready to go. Then I can substitute in the next point. So substitute in negative 2. So y equals negative 2 times negative 2 plus 1. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. 4 plus 1 equals 5. So this gives me a coordinate, negative 2, 5. So negative 2 will be along here. 5 is already labeled for me. There's my point there at negative 2, 5. Now, we could work out the rest just for the sake of time. I'm going to do these ones quickly. So that one will be 3, 1, negative 1, negative 3, positive, negative 5. So that will be there, 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 and negative 3, 5 is down here. And then from there, we can just get a straight line to draw in between all of those points, and then there is our linear relation sketched and ready to go. All right, in this example, we want to talk about finding the x and y intercepts here. So when we're finding our x intercepts, okay, we want to consider when is our y value zero. Now, going back to our definition of our x intercepts, that's where we are cutting the x axis. Now, on our x axis, our y value is zero. We can see that even here in our diagram. At this point here, when we want to find out our intercept along our x-axis here, we know the y-value is going to be 0. Just below this line, the y-value is negative 1. Just above, it's 1. So along our x-axis, our y-value is 0. So to determine our x-intercept, we just need to know, well, where is our y-value 0? Looking at our table, here is where our y value is zero. So this must be our x-intercept. So our x-intercept of our table must be negative 1, 0. Now for our y-intercept, same sort of idea, but this time we want to know when x equals zero. So our y-axis is this line here. And so we want to know, and so we know it's got an x value of 0. X is positive 1 there, negative 1 there. So on our axis, it's got a value of 0. Looking at our table, there is where our x value is 0. So our y-intercept here is going to be 0, 3 for our y-intercept there. Looking at our graph, we can just read off these coordinates very easily. So here's our x-intercept, that's where we're cutting our x-axis. That'll be negative 4, 0. And for our y-intercept, it's way up here. That will be 0 for our x-coordinate and 2 for our y. And that's how we can find our intercepts, looking at the table and using our graph there. Now, finally, to determine whether or not a point is on a line, we want to substitute the point into that equation. So that by substituting in the point, we want to substitute in the x and the y value. And then we have to just work out, is the equation true? And if the point's on the line, the equation will be true. If the point is not on the line, the equation will be false. So let's do this first one. So we have to determine whether the point 3, negative 1 is on the following lines. So our first step, we have to substitute them in. Our values, so our x value is 3, our y value is negative 1. Negative 1 equals 2 times 3 minus 7. Negative 1 equals 6. 2 times 3 is 6 minus 7. I'm just going up here. Negative 1 equals negative 1. That equation is true. So the answer to this question is yes. This point 3, negative 1 is on the line. Let's try our next one. We'll substitute our point in again. Negative 1 equals negative x. So that'll become x. So we have to sub in x equals 3. So it'll become negative 3 plus 1. Negative 1 equals negative 3 plus 1 is negative 2. That is false. Okay, negative 1 can't equal negative 2. So that's a no. This point is not on this line.
That sounds bad,
Dad. All right, so after watching this video, now you should be able to define linear relations. You should be able to sketch a linear relation using a table of ordered pairs and using substitution. Identify the x and y intercepts of a linear relation from a graph or a table. And then finally decide whether or not a point is on a given line.